वनकम, मैं हैदर अली सैयद आशीर्वाद से यूनाइटेड अंडर तमिल सेवा. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन कुरान चैप्टर 2 सेक्शन 1 वर्स फ्रॉम 1 टू 8. कुरान चैप्टर 2 वर्स 1 अलिफ लाम मीम. मेनी पीपल आर आस्किंग द मीनिंग ऑफ अलिफ लाम मीम. हियर आई कैन ओनली से दैट दे आर द अल्फाबेट्स ऑफ अरेबिक लैंग्वेज. According to tradition, Zayd bin Thabit was the personal scribe of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad. Remember, writing on palm leaves was there from the beginning. All the ancient scribes used to write few alphabets or symbols to check the quality of the palm leaves. Many ancient palm leaves manuscript, one could find few alphabets or symbol on it as a continued tradition. Even now in South Asia, people are writing some symbols called Pelayar Suzi in the very beginning, but it has no meaning. Similarly, scribe during Prophet Muhammad period to check the quality of the palm leaf could have written Alif Lam Mim Ra and other alphabets of Arabic while recording the revelation on palm leaves. There is no hidden meaning in those alphabets. Beware of the Muslim scholars who are trying to explain those letters. Remember, Allah taught the first Siddha, Tamil Shiva, Lai Said, the third son of Adam, by pen. Quran chapter 96, 1 to 5. Reading, writing, and information on all subjects taught by pen to first Siddha, Tamil Shiva, by Almighty. Tradition of writing on palm leaves was there from the beginning. To check the quality of the palm leaf, scribe used to write few alphabets on it. So that makes clear that about the alphabets such as Alif, Lam, Mim, Ra and so on, which are there in Quran. Quran chapter 2 verse 2, I read, this is the book, the Quran, about which there is no doubt, a guidance for those conscious of Allah. Conscious of Allah, a process which could be achieved through Kundalini awakening and with regular practice of meditation and yoga. Only way to be conscious of Most High is through Kundalini awakening. For Kundalini activation process, one does not need any mediator, in other words, priestly cult. In Asivigam, the real Islam, priestly cult are not entertained. Remember, priestly cult are a part of Antichrist agenda under Varnadharam. Quran chapter 2 verse 3, I read, who believe in the unseen, establish prayer and spend out of what we have provided for them. Believing in the unseen refers to believe in the Most High, believe in angel, believes on last day, in other words, judgment day. Establishing prayer and give zakat. Here Quran reminds ancient tradition of koil system where common people stands behind elected minister and take active part in administration. Thus equality between elites and the common people is established. Thus all lived in golden era. To run the government administration, people should pay taxes. Zakat means tax. Koil means house of elected king. Koil a parliament. Jumma a day behind elected minister. Standing behind a maulana, a priest, is a mockery to Koil Jumma system of Asivagam, the real Islam. Remember, priestly cult are not entertained in Asivagam, the real Islam. Quran chapter 2 verse 4, I read, and who believes in what have been revealed to you, O Muhammad, and what has been revealed before you, and of the year after, there are certain. Article of faith makes it compulsory to believe in all previous prophets and also believes in previous scriptures and revelation with their correct history as guided in Quran chapter 3 verse 33 to 34. Remember, history from Adam to Noah deals with Tamil black nation. Quran chapter 3 verse 33 talks about family of Ibrahim and Semitic black race. Remember, Ibrahim had covenant with Allah. That covenant was inherited by his children. Certain of hereafter. Remember, life on earth is temporary. We all have to die. Based on our worldly activity, God is to judge in hereafter. Beware of Varnadharam, policy of Shraddh, Pitri, Isai, Sawab, punishment in grave. Quran chapter 2 verse 5, I read, those are upon right guidance and they are lords, and it is those who are the successful. Remember, if one having correct information on all the articles of faith understands it and propagate it, they are the people who would be successful in hereafter. Quran chapter 2 verse 6, I read, as for those whose faith is disbelief, it is the same for them whether you warn them or do not warn them, they will not believe. Remember, when Quran says they, it refers to Aryan settler, Roman and Persian. When Quran says you, it refers to black natives, Tamil nation and Semitic black race. It is all the same for them, referring to settlers, whether you, O Muhammad, warn them or do not warn them, they will not believe. They, the Aryan settlers, will never accept the native way of life called Asivagam, the real Islam, which is based on creation and balance. As for Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, from genealogy of first Antichrist, Cain, the murderer, those Aryan settlers now hiding behind Muslim world are anti-spiritual and stiff-necked people. Quran chapter 2 verse 7, I read, Allah has set a seal upon their hearts and upon their hearing, and over their vision is a veil, and for them is a great punishment. Remember, Allah does not change the faith of individual until they change. Since Aryan settlers have developed the art of destroying truth, killing messengers, killing pathfinders, killing many siddhas from Tamil Nadu, an attempt to eradicate God's religion, Asivagam, the real Islam. Remember, all priestly cult is based on principle of Varnadharam and Manusastra. Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, the rebellious nature became their faith, thus closing their eyes from understanding the truth. So these Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, now hiding behind Muslim label, have set a veil on themselves with deception, lie, corruption. They want to maintain one-eyed system of Varnadharam. Aryavarta agenda in India is an agenda of Persian Aryan settlers. They are now hiding behind Muslim label and they are ruling the Muslim world from illegally occupied Mecca. So Aryavarta agenda across South Asia is an Aryan Muslim world agenda. I read the 8th line in second part of the Quran. Quran chapter 2 verse 8. And they are some people who say, we believe in Allah and the last day. However, they are not believers. Therefore, the real Islam is, and the general public must be aware of the true history and beware of them. Nandri, Vanakkam.